Dear students, in this lecture video, we detailedly studied about the remote terminal unit, that is RTU for power system, SCADA. This topic comes under second part of the module 1, that is SCADA part only. Under SCADA, we studied about the remote terminal unit for power system, SCADA. Students, the remote terminal unit is nothing but a microprocessor controlled electronic device that interfaces objects in the physical world to a distributed control system or SCADA, that is supervisory control and data acquisition system, by transmitting telemetry data. So the telemetry data may be voltage or current or circuit breaker switching status, relay status, tap changing transformer position status, switch position status, real power flow, reactive power flow, frequency, etc. These are the telemetry data to a master system, and by using messages from the master supervisory system to control connected objects. This is called as the remote terminal unit, RTU. So you already know the RTU, that is the remote terminal unit, consists of remote telemetry unit and remote telecontrol unit. So the RTU consists of both control unit. One is remote telemetry unit, another one is remote telecontrol unit. The remote terminal unit consists of architecture. The architecture, that means the remote terminal RTU monitor the field digital and analog parameters, both digital and analog parameters, which transmits data to the central monitoring station only. It contains a set of software to connect data input streams to data output stream also, define communication protocol and troubleshoot installation problems. The RTU contains what? Data output streams, define communication protocol, troubleshoot installation problem. The RTU consists of one complex circuit card, which consists of various sections needed to do the custom fitted function, or may consist of many circuit cards, which includes CPU, that is central processing unit, or the processing with communication interfaces, and one or more of the following, that means analog input AI, digital status input, which is denoted by DI, digital control or control relay output DO, and then analog output AO. So these are the cards, that means for included in the remote terminal unit. Then next, the architecture consists of the power supply, that is the remote terminal unit. So the power supply, a form of power supply will be included for performing from the AC main for various central processing units, status waiting voltages and other interface cards. This may consist of AC to DC converter, where operated from a station battery system. The RTU may include a battery and charger circuitry to continue the operation in the event of AC power failure for critical applications where the station battery is not available. Then digital inputs, that is status inputs, DI. The most remote terminal units incorporate on input section or input status cards to acquire two-state real-world information. It is usually accomplished by using an isolated voltage or current source to sense the position of the remote contact. That is, the remote contact position is either in open or closed at the RTU site. This contact position may represent many different devices, including circuit breakers, liquid valve positions, alarm conditions, and mechanical position of the devices. The counter inputs are also optional for the digital inputs. Then analog inputs. Analog inputs means the abbreviation is AI. A RTU can monitor analog inputs of the different types, including, for example, 0 to 1 milliamp, 4 to 20 milliamp current loop, 0 to 10 volt, plus or minus 2.5 volt, plus or minus 5 volt, etc. These are the analog input. Many RTU inputs buffer larger quantities via transducers to convert and isolate real world quantities from the sensitive RTU input levels. An RTU can also receive analog data via digital communication system from a master SCADA or intelligent electronic device IED, sending data value to the system also. The RTU or the host system translate and scales this raw data into the appropriate unit, such as quantity of water left, temperature degrees, megawatts, before presenting the data to the user via the human machine interface. You know, because the data collected from the remote by using RTU and which is transferred to the master SCADA through digital communication. So therefore, this is nothing but the human machine interface. The next one is digital outputs or control relay output, which is denoted by DO or CO. The remote terminal unit RTU may drive high current capacity relay to a digital output board to switch power on or on and off to the device in the field. The digital output board switches voltage to the coil in the relay, which closes the high current contacts, which completes the power circuit to the device. The RTU outputs may also consist of the driving a sensitive logic input on electronic PLC or other electronic device using sensitive 5 volt input. Then analog output. While it is not as a commonly used, analog outputs may be included to control devices that require varying quantities, such as graphic recording instruments. The example is strip charts. Okay, the summed and the processed data quantities may be generated in a master SCADA system and the output for display locally or remotely whenever needed. This is the function of analog output. The next one is software and logic control. You know, because this is full and full automatic, so all the performance is done by the software part only. So the modern RTUs are usually capable for executing simple programs autonomously without involving the host computer, that is the master SCADA of the distribution, that is the control system or the SCADA system, to simplify deployment and to provide redundancy for safety reasons. An RTU in a modern water management system will typically have the hood to modify its behavior when physical override switches on the RTU are toggled during maintenance by the maintenance personnel. This is done for safety reason, that is a miscommunication between the system operators and the maintenance personnel could cause system operators to mistakenly enable power to a water pump when it is being replaced. For example, the maintenance persons would have any equipment they are working on disconnected from power and locked to prevent damage and or injury only. The last component of the remote terminal unit is communication. The RTU may be interfaced to multiple master stations and intelligent electronic device IED with different communication media. Usually, what are the communications we are used? Serial communication, that is RS-232, RS-485, RS-422 or Ethernet. These are the things is used as a serial communication for collecting data from the remote location through remote terminal unit which send to master data. Okay, dear student, in this lecture video we clearly understand the what is the function, what are the component, what is the operation of the remote terminal unit for power system SCADA. Thank you student for listening this video.